Hi, this is Shop Talk, and I'm Ria Tanuat-Cotrillo. It's been an amazing 2011 for us here on the show. Not only did we give you over 250 episodes, but in the process, we met a lot of young, inspiring entrepreneurs, and we got reacquainted with former guests whose businesses have expanded from the last time we had them here. Of course, we also talked a lot about money. The country's top personal finance practitioners and advocates talked about making money and growing it through investments. We also had a lot of smart money advice from the experts, and here are some of them. So what's the first thing a person has to do if they really want to look at their financial situation?
Well, if a person is starting to set up a financial plan, the first thing he has to understand is himself, no? What is his current wealth already? Do they have his existing assets? How about his liabilities? At the end of the day, how much is his net worth? No, that's the first thing that a person has to understand. The second thing that a person has to understand is his cash flow. No, when you talk about cash flow, you talk about, for example, his salary, his income in business, even interest income, and of course, what are the potential outflow, which are most likely his expenses. Those are the first two things that the person has to understand. No?
Okay, so you suggest, you know, putting up a personal balance sheet. And is this something you recommend a person do on his or her own, or is it better to really sit down with somebody like you or an accountant to get an accurate picture of their situation?
If a person is just starting, he can actually do it by himself, no? Because basically his assets are still small. Probably he doesn't have any liabilities yet, no? But it's okay, of course, if you ask for advice, because, you know, at the very start, you already know what to do, no? At least you're in the right track.
It's really nice to set a budget and see it on paper, but it's another thing to actually implement and manifest it. What are your tips for actually sticking to the budget that you make?
Well, the most important thing is you have to write it down, and you have to monitor it, no? If the viewer needs an Excel copy of a budget sheet, I can actually provide them. We can give them an email address later on.
Okay.
But what I do is that I have a budget sheet, and it actually mirrors what my actual cost is. So what I do on another sheet is all my actual costs, I actually monitor it on that portion. The way it happened is my actual cost versus my budget, they compare it. And if there's a discrepancy, I can immediately adjust it. No, that's a nice thing about you monitoring it on a more regular basis, because you can see it kagad.
Okay, so you really kailangan nakatutok ka
yes,
talaga
yes.
when you do this this sort of thing. Okay, what other tips do you have on when it comes to budgeting aside from that?
Well, again, no, other than the fact that you need to keep on monitoring it, you also have to make sure that you're conscious moving forward, no? Mm-hmm. Because at the end of the day, if I have my outflow, what I always do is I already set up a portion wherein I already have an outflow on savings. So not only that, when I talk about outflow in terms of expenses, I also talk about part of my outflow as my savings already, because in the last episode that we had, no, mm-hmm. one of the best formula that I keep on sharing is that the best solution for us to be able to save is income minus savings equals expenses. So as you budget, you already start saving up already. So,
okay, so
from the very start pa lang, tinabi mo na kagad yung savings mo.
Okay, so that should be inputted in your regular budget.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so then that way, at least if you end up not following the budget, you sort of also have a fallback.
Yes.
To help you out in case you're not following what you set out to do.
Yes. In fact, something that if a person would have a difficult time in using computers or Excel, there's a substitute for it. You can use what we call as an envelope budgeting, no?
Okay.
Wherein you have a couple of envelopes, and you already write down what are your potential expenses. For example, there's one envelope that says Meralco, another one for water, and so on. So the moment that you get your salary, you can already allot it in the envelopes.
Okay, stuff it in there, seal it,
yes,
don't touch it anymore.
No. The nice thing about it is that, you know, what you don't see, you don't spend.
Right.
Now the sad thing is, if once you get your salary and it's all in your pocket,
it's just gonna fly out of there.
Exactly, and right. That's exactly why every 15th and 30th you see restaurants are jam packed. No. because of that.
That's true. Everybody wants to treat themselves after 2 weeks of hard work. Nothing wrong with that, of course, as long as it's within your budget.
When you talk, we talk about money, my philosophy is, it's not how much money you make that's more important, it's how much money you save.
Right.
Even though you make 100,000 pesos, but if your lifestyle is 120,000, you still be in debt, you have no savings. Mm-hmm. Even though you're making only 15,000 to 20,000 a month, but if you live below that, you have savings, at the same time, you are not in debt.
Right.
But tendency of people, they do not look at the savings part, but they look at the outside, the car that you drive, where you live, and everything. Mm-hmm. So there's the pitfall of most people. And that's the reason why I always tell people, Raquel, the best thing in life is do not ever compare yourself with other people.
Uh-huh.
There are two negative things that will happen. It's either you become proud because you're ahead of other people, or you become frustrated because other people are way ahead of you. Number one, you have to change the way you think. If you change the way you think, you will change the way you live. I like to share to you a simple formula. It's called mindset plus action equivalent to result. Mm-hmm. When you have a negative mindset, negative action, negative result. Poor mindset, poor action, poor result. Positive mindset, positive action, positive result. Rich mindset, rich action, rich result.
Okay.
You have to change the way you think. You have no choice to whose parent you were born to, your environment. But as you grow old, you have choices in life.
Mm-hmm.
Choose to become a winner. Don't choose to become a loser. I can still recall my parents told me, if you want to become a millionaire, you have to learn how to save with 1 peso. If you don't have a 1 peso, you won't have 100.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have 100, you won't have 1,000. If you don't have 1,000, you won't have hundreds of thousands and millions.
Mm-hmm.
So if you don't know the habit of saving 1 peso, you won't even reach that. You won't reach that amount.
When there's a need that comes from a relative or a charitable organization, then we have another budget for that as well. So it's worked in our budget up to 20 to 30%.
I think because a lot of people think, okay, I'll give when I have extra.
Right.
But of course, you hardly ever have any extra because there's always something and something and something else that you need you need to spend on.
Yeah.
Okay, back to the lotto winners who give too much of their money away. How do you know, like that, if a needy relative or friend comes up to you and, you know, they're asking for some kind of financial assistance, how much is enough? You know, enough that you're sharing, enough to help them, but not too much.
That's a very good and tricky question.
It's a tough question. That's why being united is very important.
Yeah.
And you know what? Most of the time, the amount that I have on my mind is exactly the same amount that RD has.
Yeah.
It comes to being together for 21 years. So
we don't keep secrets. I mean, we don't give to someone and then we keep it a secret. Oh,
okay.
She might find out.
That's really bad.
Yeah. But I think the answer there, Ria, is that to give to people who will also help themselves. There's a book called The Millionaire Next Door that says, if you keep on giving to someone who becomes dependent on that help, they become an economic outpatient. They become so used to and dependent on your giving that they'll just wait every month like para mo sinasweldohan. So that's not
common,
the kind of person that you
here.
Help.
Yeah.
You help someone who helps us, or an organization that is fertile, that good soil.
Okay, and what if a couple, you know, doesn't agree on the kind of investment instrument they want to pour their money into? What's a good way of resolving that?
Well, the biblical concept is the husband is the leader.
Okay.
He's supposed to be the leader.
And she's the neck.
So I tell him where to turn.
And the head, and she's the neck. No,
so anyway, he's supposed to know, he's supposed to have that wisdom to decide, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we support him. And you know, it's also a biblical concept, Ria, that he is more accountable to God. So it's like the pressure is off the female, the
if
wives.
If I mess up, it's
if he messes up, it's his fault. Yes.
Oh dear.
Yeah.
Yes.
But in our system, in the family, I always tell her where the money's going.
Yes.
But if I believe in a woman's sixth sense and
intuition,
we have intuition.
Instinct,
so
yes.
If she says that this doesn't seem right, then I don't.
Yes.
And in a lot of instances where she said, honey, it looks so normal.
I'm always
parang malabo.
Right.
It's like, and I still go through it. She's always right.
Up next, we'll bring you back some practical advice and words of wisdom from an entrepreneurship guru and franchising expert. So stay with us. Shop Talk will be right back.